As a bow hunter, I'm a firm believer that repetition is key. Whether that's practicing, whether it's hunting, the more time you spend on stand, usually the better your odds. But what people don't want to do is you don't want to become complacent. You don't want to get to the fact where you're just out there going through the motions and you're not even paying attention. Let's face it, all of us, we probably have no idea how many deer have been missed because people have their heads buried in their phones. The number one thing I see is people are putting in the time on stand, but they're not putting in quality time. If you're going to take the time to go out there and to sit, try to be as mentally focused as absolutely possible. In my opinion, that's the difference between great bow hunters and amazing bow hunters, is that they are mentally prepared and they have everything ready. Get on stand and get organized. The very first thing I like to do is when I get on stand, put my release on, draw my bow, and make sure nothing's in my way. Make sure my safety harness is out of the way and that I am ready to go. I've got an arrow knock, my release on, and if a buck just so happens to come through right away, I am ready for it. You want to make sure that you are ready as soon as possible because you may not get a second chance. A lot of big deer, you only get one opportunity at them, and it's up to you to be ready and to be prepared. So much of this has to do with focus. It has to do with mental preparation. If you're sitting on stand, you've got all day. So think about, where are the deer coming through? Where can you see them? Where can you start getting ready? Where can you draw? Where is somewhere that you have a little bit of cover? And then where's your shot gonna be? How are you gonna stop them? Do you have a little scent down on the ground? Are you gonna grunt when you're at full draw? What is the plan? The more you can go through that in your head, the less likely you're gonna be to becoming complacent and not getting your things together when that once of a lifetime opportunity may come through. And you may have seconds to make sure that everything is in order. And if it's not, it's just gonna be a hard lesson learned. So try to avoid that if possible. Also, I can't tell you the number of deer that I have taken during those midday hours. Literally from 10 to 2 is some of the best hunting time I have ever been a part of. If you're hunting a pressured area, a lot of people are getting down from their stand or going in for lunch and they stir up deer around the area. So if you're sitting on stand and you are ready midday, you will be amazed at the number of deer that have been taken and big bucks that are on the move in the middle of the day. So if I can give anyone a piece of advice, it would be to stay focused, to be ready, keep your head out of your phone, and hunt the midday hours as well. Stay up there as long as possible. The more time on stand, the higher your chance of success. So try to get out there to have fun, to enjoy that time, but stay focused and make the best of it.